Right after we show the temperatures around the world.
Very good.
You've seen her. Jerry Taft has introduced her. Aaron Gold has a guest today, Marilyn Chambers. Aaron?
Well, all I can say is that for 2 months, or at least the length of time I've been here, the director has never asked for a meeting with me, and I just got a message. Please stick around to talk to the director afterward. With you.
Oh, okay.
With you, with you.
You were
about 2.5 feet inside the building, and one of our women said, when you do an X-rated film and you undress and you do things on screen, how do you feel after the movie is finished and it's out and people are looking at you, and men especially, do you feel uncomfortable if you think that they're disrobing you with their eyes?
Oh, I love it. Are you kidding? What woman wouldn't love that? If she does, she doesn't, she's crazy.
Well, I think there's a lot of women that wouldn't want to admit it.
That's true. But I don't feel guilty about anything I've done, so I'm having a good time.
You made a movie with Barbara Streisand. You starred in Las Vegas in a legitimate play, The Man with the Dirty Mind.
Mind with the Dirty Mind.
Mind with the Dirty Man.
Okay.
For a year.
Yes.
You've just made a television movie in two versions. Why two versions?
Well, one is for cable, which we all know the advent of that is going to be a very big thing. And one for regular.
Does that mean one is X-rated and one is
no,
not?
No, it's not X. They're calling it hard R because it's... I mean, there's all these different things, like soft X, hard X, hard
R. You sing, soft, you dance, know, you do movies, you do television, you do nightclubs. Why do you choose to do X-rated films?
Simply because it turns me on. You know, and I think that it's important to do something that you really enjoy, and I mean, if people are going to come watch me, then I'll keep doing it.
Do you make a great deal of money doing something like this?
Yeah, pretty good amount.
Do you have a hand, so to speak, in helping pick your leading man?
In picking my leading man, I was going to ask you if you wanted to co-star in my next film. Honestly.
Well, if Arnold Schwarzenegger lets me work out with him for about a year and a half or 2 years, you know, to put everything back where it belongs.
Yeah, you look
maybe.
Great.
But seriously, do you get a chance, or are you instrumental at all in saying, I want him, I don't want him, he's not good enough?
I don't like to ever say I want him. You know, because I feel that it's much more fun if it's a surprise. It makes it more interesting, definitely. But if it's somebody who I really, who's really horrible, it just really turns me off. I'm a good enough actress where I could do it.
Okay. Well, all right, I'll buy that. Chuck Traynor has been managing you for the last 7 years. You've been on again, off again, a romantic item. He had managed and was married to Linda Lovelace.
Right.
Is he the Svengoolie that she claimed he was?
Well, you know, that word always kind of throws me for a loop because I look at it in a good way. For me, it's been terrific. I wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for Chuck, and he's about the nicest guy, sorry, Chuck, to ruin your reputation, that I've ever met. And what Linda wrote horrible things in her book about him. Personally, I've never met Linda, so I can't say too much against her because that wouldn't be fair. But from what I know and the people that knew them when they were together, none of it is true.
Do you have plans to get married?
No.
Do you have plans to have children?
Jerry.
Sorry, Jerry. She doesn't want to get married.
No.
He's wearing his sex star.
All right.
You don't want to have children?
No, I really don't think that it would fit with my lifestyle.
If you were to have children, would you want one of your daughters to pursue this line of endeavor?
Sure. Hypothetically, if I had a daughter, I would never push anybody into anything. But if she came to me and said, hey, Mom, I want to be in a film with John Holmes or somebody, how could I say no?
I don't know. Who's John Holmes?
Oh, okay. Well, we'll talk about that later.
Obviously, it's something we can't talk about on the air.
Oh, no. He's one of the biggest males. Oh, well, I mean, the most famous male sex stars.
I think I get the picture. I can tell by looking at you.
Okay.
You're appearing tonight where?
At the Admiral Theatre. It's on West Lawrence. I will be there two more times this evening, and then I'll be there through Monday. I believe it's three or four times a day I'll be signing autographs, and I haven't been in the Chicago area for a long time, so I'm excited about seeing you.
Jerry Taft arranged this weather just for you today.
Oh, I love it.
Former Ivory Snow lady, thanks so much for joining us today.
My pleasure.
Back to you, Chuck and Linda.
Thank you, Aaron. Jerry Taft today.
Is he the Svengoolie that she claimed he was? Is he the Svengoolie that she claimed he was?